This is Connie, and we're going to take a look at the statement of cash flows. This video is using the indirect method. I also do a video using the direct method. First of all, look at the sheet titled Cash Flow Summary Sheet. It looks like this. It actually has a summary of the steps that we are going to do for the indirect method. So use that as a guideline. Then you have another file, Chapter 6, Indirect Method of Cash Flows. That is a sample problem for you to work, and I'm actually going to work that sample problem with you here. First of all, I looked at some of the account balances for two different years, 2015 and 2014, and I looked to see if they went up in 2015 compared to what it was in 2014. So for example, cash was $43,000 in 2014. It's now gone up to $106,500. So if I take the difference, it's gone up by $63,500. AR was $70,000 and now it's $65,000. So I take the difference, it's actually gone down by $5,000. And I do the same thing for each one of these accounts that you see listed here. Now what the statement of cash flows is looking at is it's looking at what cash is going in and what cash is going out. For example, when you deposit your paycheck, you have cash going in your account. When you pay a bill with cash, you have cash going out of your account. And that's simply what we're doing here for the company. Some additional information, depreciation is $20,000, investments sold for $5,500, equipment and land were purchased and none was disposed of or sold, common stock was issued for cash, retained earnings was credited for $44,000, which represents the net income for the year. And dividends declared, notice it says declared, not paid, was $3,000. Now the statement of cash flows is divided into three parts: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. The operating activities is the part that is different for the indirect versus the direct method. So let's do the operating activities first. It starts with the net income. In letter D, the net income is given to you at $44,000. Presume we previously did the income statement, so I'll fill that in. The next part, adjust to reconcile net income to net cash flow from operating activities. We first look to see if we sold any investments at a gain or a loss. It does say in A that we sold investments for $5,500. If you go back up to the account balances that I gave you, investments were $5,000, so that would be its cost, and now it's down to zero. So we sold all $5,000 of our investments at $5,500. So therefore, $5,500 minus $5,000 means we sold them at a $500 gain. Gains are actually subtracted out. If it were loss, that would actually be added back in. Depreciation is always added back in because it is actually a non-cash expense. For example, here it says depreciation is $20,000, so I'll add that back in. On your income statement, depreciation is taken out as an expense, but yet you do not pay out cash when your car depreciates, like you would pay out cash for a utility bill. So therefore, depreciation doesn't affect the cash flow, so we have to add it back in. Next thing we look at is changes in current operating assets and liabilities. Now we don't look at cash here. So our other current assets I've highlighted in red are account receivable, inventories, and prepaids. We look at if they went up or down between the 2 years, and then we actually do the opposite. So for example, AR went down by $5,000. So I will add that difference of $5,000 back in. Inventories went up by $11,000. So I will subtract that $11,000 out. Prepaid expenses, such as maybe prepaid insurance, went down by $500. So therefore, I will add that $500 in. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the liabilities. We have two liabilities listed. Those liabilities are accounts payable and salaries payable, highlighted in green here. If they go up, we add them in. If they go down, we subtract them out. So accounts payable went down by 7,000. So we do go ahead and subtract that out. And salaries payable went up by 1,000. So I go ahead and add that back in. Now, to get my net operating activities, net operating cash flows, I will add all of these together. So I will start with net income, add all the way through. And my net cash flow from operating activities is $52,000. Please continue on with the second video on the indirect method, and we will take a look at the investing and financing activities. Thank you very much.